Continuing our discussion on probabilities and the rules of probabilities, let's take a look at what's known as the general addition rule. Okay, the general addition rule, here's the idea. We have given two arbitrary events, call them A and B. The probability that A occurs or B occurs. Remember, joint probability was A and B. Okay, this is an or. So the probability that A occurs or B occurs is given as the probability of A or B. Remember, the joint probability we had the intersection, which was like an upside down U to indicate that, or the union is a U, equals the probability of A plus the probability of B minus the probability of A and B. So the probability of A or B equals the sum of the individual probabilities minus the joint probability. And the reason we have to subtract off that joint probability can probably show it best if we do a quick Venn diagram. If this is the event A, and this is the event B, well, if A is all of this, and B is all of this, if I take a look at A plus B, I've counted this area right here. I'm going to fill it in solid. I've counted that area twice. Okay, I only want it once, A or B. I can't count something twice. So if I subtract it off once, then what I end up with is that joint area included in the calculation only once, not included twice. So that's the reason that we have to subtract these two off. Okay, now, in the special case where we have events A and B being mutually exclusive, that's kind of cool. Because if we know A and B are mutually exclusive, the Venn diagram will look like this. They don't overlap. So if they're mutually exclusive, then I know right away that this is simply zero, so I can get rid of it. And the probability of two mutually exclusive events is simply the probability of A plus the probability of B, the sum of their individual probabilities. Okay, now let's take a look at the freshman or less than 5 years. So I want to find the probability of a freshman or ours is less than 5. And actually I need to change that because it should be less than or equal, because that's what I have on my table. So 5 hours or less is what I'm really saying. Okay, so I want the probability of a freshman plus the probability that ours is less than or equal to 5. I need to subtract from that the probability of a freshman, probability of freshman and ours is less than or equal to 5. So let's get these piece by piece and put it together. The probability of a freshman is 66 out of 280. Plus the probability to work less than 5 hours, or less than or equal to 5 hours, that is 63 out of 280. Minus the joint probability. Well, I have less than 5 hours, and I have freshmen. The joint probability is going to be 24 out of 280. That's freshmen and work less than or equal to 5 hours. So this is minus 24 out of 280. You can do the arithmetic on this and actually get an answer. Remember earlier I said for my students that if you report a negative probability or probably greater than 1, then you lose more points as possible. This is exactly the situation where it can occur. If, as an example, not in this particular case, but I'm sure you can see that in some examples, if you forget this, if you forget to subtract off a piece, what you added up, the two components you added together, could be bigger than 1. It won't be in this particular case, because 66 and 63 is, 129, which is still less than 280. But if there were more in those categories, you could end up with, 297 out of 280, which is greater than 1, which is why you need to remember to subtract off the right piece. Or if you add up these wrong, you pick the wrong events, and the sum of these is less than what you're subtracting, you could, in fact, end up with a negative probability. Now, it's not truly a negative probability. It's not truly a probability greater than 1. When I say that you could add up with a negative probability, really all I'm saying is that your calculations could result in a negative answer, which is clearly wrong. So really, that's all there is to the general addition rule. Let's review very quickly the actual equation for it. The probability of A or B equals the probability of A, the probability of the first event, plus the probability of B, the probability of the second event, minus the probability of A and B. If we're talking about empirical data, then we simply come back and put little hats on these guys, and we're okay. That's it.